What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the 11th Hour Gaming Channel. I'm AJ Gills. We are back playing Alan Wake. Oh, I'm sorry. I love this game so much. I'm like, this is I'm not a big fan of horror games. I make my exception with this game. And I hope you aren't following my terrible example. I'm being a little girl and, I'm sorry, that's sexist. I'm being a little baby and playing with the lights on. But I suggest to you guys, to get the full experience, please turn the lights off, put in some headphones, sit up, curl up with your nice favorite beverage, and just have a good old time. Oh, God, what was the line from Death Race? It's dim the lights, the carnage is about to begin, something like that. I love the Jason Statham Death Race movie. Not gonna lie, I like the Lou Goss sequel. Right in his face. I love how the crosshair in this game it's replaced by the flashlight. That's just such a clever idea. That is probably my favorite my favorite thing that they did in this game. And I don't know why. I know it's such a simple thing, but it's just such a good idea that I don't think anybody else would have thought of. I like that. Episode, a family occasion. All right, you know, normally, I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna sit and watch that. If you ever want me to stop and stare at those things, tell me. I'll be happy to do it.
Surged towards me, sucking everything loose from the ground into its depths, tugging at my clothes. I saw the flare the kidnapper had dropped and threw myself towards it just as I felt my feet leave the ground. The darkness embraced me with the force of a tornado. Somehow I managed to light the flare. The darkness roared and cast me away. I fell toward the dark waters of the lake far below.
That's not scary. Come on. Come on. I know you're here. And that was kind of right. Damn it. It's really hard to dodge that thing. Which I know, that's a weird way to say that because, you know, it's a truck. Take the flares. I think it's because I'm dumb and I don't utilize my flares as much as I should. Holy hell! Holy! Oh my god! Like, I knew there was another one. I knew it. Holy crap! Oh my god. Okay, I can't get up there to go explore. Holy shoot. Oh. Call me a wuss, call me whatever you want. Like, that was... I don't have words for what that was. That was freaking terrifying.
Never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now.
You know, it looked like there was...
Today, I would meet the kidnapper.
And yeah, see, there's more else. Road.
I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw.
Why get out of the car? There's more road.
Without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
Jeez, what was the lineup from Dwight in the office? It was something when he was saying how he keeps weapons all over the office. And he's like, could you imagine if I was deranged? I don't know why that popped in my head. I think it was with him saying that he matches a textbook case of insanity. What the hell? I hit like a imaginary wall. Oh, cool, I'm gonna drive in style after I search this place.
This is Pat Main, and you're listening to KBS FM, folks.
See, I know this,
apologize for kind of
I'm trying to think, what is it? These fire watch towers, or I don't know actually what they're called. You know, we got to hang out in one of these. If you watched my Firewatch Let's Play, yeah, that's what we were hanging out in. Nah, I don't feel like exploring that place now. It watches, there was like probably cool stuff in there.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
Oh, and look how I actually have no choice to get but to get out of the car.
With Nightingale gone and the night wind blowing in through the broken studio window, Main stared at Sarah. The sheriff looked away. Main's voice shook with barely controlled anger. That boy's doing more drinking than thinking. I hope you know what you're doing, Sarah. He's got a sickness in his eyes. You take my word for it. He wants Wake for a reason, and it's not for anything good.
Yup. That's about all I can say about that. Yeah, you can pause and read that if you'd like.
I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back, or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
Wake!
Where the hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello? Ah! I'm gonna kill him!
Man, that guy's kind of an asshole.
Mirror Peak.
Oh, crap. Holy shit.
It was close. Maybe closer than ever before.
See, I like how we keep all the ammo and like the flashlight upgrade that we had from the last video, or from like before the cutscene. I know that's a weird, I mean, like, of course we're like on the same chapter, episode, whatever, however you want to, you know, kind of like split this game up. So yeah, why wouldn't he have the same equipment? I think a lot of games probably wouldn't. I don't know.
When Thomas Zane fell for Barbara Jagger, it happened fast. She was young, vibrant, and beautiful, full of life. He had never been a very happy man, and without any seeming effort, she had changed all that. Zane felt good for the first time in his life. Everything she did was another piece of a jigsaw puzzle he hadn't even known he'd been missing. And best of all, she made the words flow, strong and sharp. She was his muse.
That sounds nice. Why are there just crates of... Why is there just like a crate full of revolver bullets? Can't touch this. Ah! Ah! Eat flare, stupids! Stop it! Oh, right before it got me. Okay, there we go. That's how we switch between those. I like those sounds. There we go.
What the hell?
All right, let's look on the bright side. It's not Godzilla. That was my original fear.
The hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
I honestly thought I was going to use a flare. I forgot I equipped flashbangs. Oh, that was pretty good. I waited for to get them all together. That was a good shot. I do say so myself. Alright, a flare gun. This has got to be my favorite gun in the entire game. Well, the hunting rifle's pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, that's great. The hunting rifle's pretty good. I mean, come on. The great thing about the it's not terrifying at all. The great thing about the hunting rifle is it's all one shot kill and it gets rid of them. Gets rid of a bunch of stuff at once. Oh, goody. More of them. Crap. Come on. Thank you. God damn it. Man, like, inanimate objects are killing me more than the actual enemies. Do those things actually, like, blow up when I shoot them? Come on, I dodged that. Damn it! Alright, note to self. Do not run that direction before dealing with the enemies. There we go. Oh, okay. I do blow up. There he. I like that. Man, for the days that. Did exactly what I thought it would. I'm gonna try and take the slow and take the objects flying at me one at a time. Somehow that sounded dirty. Careful with how many bullets I use, I'm low. Alright, third time's the charm. Holy shit balls. Knives at me? Dick. Yes, bullets. gotta remember to use those things. For some reason, I didn't know that you could shoot those things to basically use them like flashbangs. Okay, so I don't have any flashbangs. All I have is flares. Yeah, that's not creepy or anything. You know, just, you know, a red chair and a spooky light and, you know, with a thermos on it.
Some of the Taken retained echoes of their former selves. But these were just the nerve twitches of a dead thing. Nothing remained but a shell covered and filled with darkness. In most cases, these puppets were enough for the purposes of the dark presence. But for anything more elaborate, as with the writer, it was different. It needed his mind. And so rather than taking him over completely, it merely touched him.
Ooh. That got a little sexy. You know, that's also not creepy, the, you know, the iridescent paint. Saying, follow. It's not spooky at all.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Are you complaining? Ah! You know, I've tried that. Gripping a flashlight harder does not make the thing brighter. And I know what you're all thinking. Yeah, he actually tried to do that with a flashlight. What a moron. I'll say this, everything's worth trying once. Goody, there's more of them.
I stared through the bars of the jail cell. Barry stood behind me, swaying on his feet, looking as ill as I felt. Agent Nightingale stood on the other side of the bars with Sheriff Breaker. Nightingale had a stack of manuscript pages in his hand. He seemed unhinged as he gloated. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here, all the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent.
What the hell? Talk about unhinged. Great, I have one bullet left. Oh crap, no! Yeah, fine.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Now we're packing. Oh, screw you, my natural curiosity. I don't even know if there's anything up here. Oh, yay, more of them. Oh wow, am I actually going towards the... So I keep seeing bushes and think they're, I think they're the Taken, that's what they're called. Oh, okay, so I could have gone either way, alright. Damn it. That swarmed. I was trying to get out my, get those flat. Ah, this is the checkpoint.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Alright, let's try this way. Let's go for some variety. Oh, Christ. Jeez, I have a... I forgot, I had the flare gun. Damn good cup of coffee. Totally forgot I had the flare gun.
Oh,
I think it was the last video where I said, you know, the flare gun's, you know, my favorite weapon in this game, and I think I've forgotten to use it. I could have saved my ass last video. Why the heck didn't I use the flare gun? Come one, come all.
The dark presence was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
Yeah, all these wooden crosses, that doesn't make me feel spooked out to be where I am. Ah.
Shift may cause cancer.
Holy! There we go. Sorry guys, I know this video has gone on a little longer than the previous ones. I thought I split the last one at kind of a good halfway point, but apparently I did not. So like usual, I'll play to the end of the chapter or story or the episode, whatever the hell it is. I mean, if it hits about 45 minutes, I'll probably call it short at a checkpoint.
The place was dead, a ghost town, had been for decades, maybe a century.
Holy! Okay.
Things were never as simple in real life as in fiction. I had lost count of the times I had wished there'd be a clear reason for my writer's block. Something to fight. Something to lash out on. There wasn't. I was filled with doubt. I was nothing like the hero in my books. Alex Casey had gone through his life with single-minded determination, never wavering from his goal. Even now, I was angry at myself. Angry at Alice. Angry at Barry. I was fumbling and I had no plan.
Jeez, my dog just scared the crap out of me. Heard my little dog run up. Heard the sounds and it freaked the shit out of me. Aww. I have the cutest dog ever.
Yes, I do.
Okay, I'm sorry. Had to make cute dog noises at my dog. When I'm the only one home like I am now, I like to leave the door to my room open. So she can kind of come and sit out in the hallway and hang out. She kind of sits there and naps.
Hey,
why you needed to hear about my dog. Yeah, man, I'm freaking out. Oh, crap. Some of these achievements, I want to know what they're for. Like, it's so weird, you know. Like when I'm playing these 360 games through the backwards compatibility, seeing that it kind of does that, where it pops achievements like it used to, you know, where it doesn't tell you what it's for. I miss those days. Well, I guess that's the days I'm in. You know what I mean.
Ah. Anything outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake.
Oops.
Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit.
Sorry about that. I accidentally pressed the button. Normally I love the hunting rifle, but now when I have a pump action shotgun. And also so much ammo for said pump action shotgun. I'm afraid to end this episode because, like, I know if I don't, this episode's gonna be like 30, like an hour and 32 minutes. But like, I have some weird OCD, and I know if I like end this episode without.
The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up.
Like, I know if I don't end this episode, I'm going to, or if I do end this episode, I'm going to hit, like, a, I don't know, it's going to throw off the way this recording's where I'm kind of doing, like, two videos, episode of in-game, so, it, you know, I don't know, it's one of those, like, I'm, like, sitting here going to myself, no, don't end the episode, because, you know, if the next time you start, you're going to be here for, like, 2 seconds. So, you know what? This episode's just going to be a little long for you guys. God, I like this music. Oh good, oh good, oh good. Stupid birds. Getting out that way.
Alan.
Holy shh. I'm not gonna explore. When your wife's disembodied voice is screaming to you when you're inside a mine, it's about the time that you don't you don't go off the beaten path. All right, bring on what's ever gonna come at me. Called it.
Closed doors and curtains of his grimy room at the Majestic, the local motel. Nightingale could feel the locals' eyes on him, the unrelenting pressure of their judgment. He forced it out of his mind. For all he knew, they could all be under Wake's spell already. You do what you have to do to get the job done. He took comfort from the bottle in his hand. Please, he thought, just let me get through this.
Yeah, that sounds like the mind of a guy you want, as an FBI agent.
To make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Tell me, why do all horror games need, like, a mine level? Like, I'm serious. It's in, like, every... Like, I've seen them in Silent Hill. I've seen them in... Jeez, Silent... Why is my brain hurt? Silent Hill, I've seen them in Resident Evil. That's the other one I was thinking of. I'm serious. Every horror game has something where you have to go into a mine. Thank you. There we go. Oh, crap. That was my bad. I hear those creaks. The creaks in the wood. And I'm just going, yo, go. Alright, I'm out of the mine. I don't think this is where I was supposed to go. That was actually kind
of
cool.
Lightning flashed behind the windows of Cauldron Lake Lodge. Tor Anderson laughed and held the steel hammer above his head. Nurse Sinclair was trying to calm him down without success. Tor grinned madly and shouted, "My hammer's up. Here's a friendly poke from Mjolnir, wench." He brought the hammer down with all his might on Sinclair's head. "We're on a comeback tour, baby."
Okay, that sounded like he was trying to do like a Duke Nukem impression. Alright guys, you know what? I'm going to end the video here. It pains me to do so because I know it's, I don't know. I know this next one, I don't know. My OCD. But guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying the game. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, my website down in the description below. Feel free to hit me up in the comments if you want to talk to me. Always happy to talk with you guys. Other than that, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. You know, you're enjoying the videos. You know, you want to give me some love. You want to help support the channel and you know, all that. Tell your friends. Check out all the other stuff going on. All that stuff, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Jeez. So guys, I guess until next time, get rid of these birds. So until next time, guys, I'm AJ Gels, this is the Dark Gaming Channel. Thank you to everybody so much for watching. I'm out.